What's up? Welcome inside another edition of Jadee's Vlog. My name is Jadee, and today we have a special episode. Have you heard about the gospel emerge? Have you heard about emerge? It's the gospel challenge, Trinidad and Tobago version. No, you have not? Well, let me tell you a little bit about it. Skylar, come out of the trunk.
Sorry.
Why are you always in the trunk? It's all about Emerge Gospel Challenge Trinidad and Tobago 2018, where we want to find out who's the next top gospel sound minister. We want to encourage them, give them the tools they need to make it in this ministry life. Holy pop prizes, man, $25,000, man going all over Bahamas to minister. Even right here in Trinidad and Tobago for Glow, production by Showing Gardner, Fisherman Projects, and a whole lot of things I can't remember right now. But stay locked on to Emerge Gospel Challenge Trinidad and Tobago. And you want to know what I do in here? I get to interview the contestants, find out who they are, what's the story, where they come from, what they're doing, what they want. And basically give them my experience as being an interviewer and being interviewed as well throughout my years and experience in gospel music. And this episode of Emerge Gospel Challenge Trinidad and Tobago is sponsored by my sponsors, King's Lounge Barber Spa, the premier barber spa for men, and of course, Wendy's. And all the contestants get a free voucher from Wendy's, so they could go into any outlet, present the voucher, and they get a free meal. And King's Lounge Barber Spa, they are also giving the contestants a 15% off voucher, where they could go to King's Lounge and have a 15% off. Have a good time down here. All right, I'm excited to go meet the contestants. Let's go meet my girl Janelle. Janelle, where you?
Hi, and welcome to another episode of Emerge Gospel Challenge 2018. I am your host, Janelle Barron, and this week we have a special one for you. Joining us today is none other than Jadee. Yes, gospel sensation Jadee. So guys, keep it locked on as we begin this week's episode.
I'm reaching for the stars. I'm gonna make it. I know who I am. This path I'm taking.
Let me get the business out of the way. Good evening.
Hi,
how are you going?
I'm cool.
All right, so here's your voucher from Wendy's, and of course 15% off of King's Lounge Barber Spa. It's the premier barber spa for men.
Nice.
Who are you?
Well, I'm Brendan Prince. Well, fun, regular, normal, average guy.
Okay, all right, all right. We'll come back to that. Brendan, what church is it?
Jesus Life Center.
Jesus Life Center. Shout out your pastor. What's your pastor's name?
We changed pastors about 2 weeks ago now.
Okay.
So the pastor who was there before was Mario Lane.
All right, good. Tell me something. What was the winning factor in your life that you said, this is it, I need to give my life to Jesus, I want to be saved?
I don't think it was a winning factor, but I mean, I have religious family and I just grew up in church. So it just went along with it.
All right, so let me understand.
Mm-hmm.
You have a religious family.
I was fortunate to grow up. We haven't grew up in church.
So you grew up in church?
Yeah.
And you got saved at what age?
Around 12, 13, around there.
12, 13, right. So that's pretty young. 12.
Uh-huh.
My daughter's 13. So from since 12, you got baptized at 12?
No, I got baptized about 16, around 16.
16?
Yeah.
So there must have been, I think, a decision where you say, I want to make this thing serious. I want to be serious for Jesus. You could remember what happened around that time, or?
No, because it was just...
Are you saying? Part,
yes,
I am. I want to make sure.
I am, but it's part and parcel of my life. So right. It was nothing to decide.
Okay, yeah. I understand. Let me put you in a scenario, because we're doing scenarios.
Oh, okay.
I am a sinner, and I come to you and say, I just want to, you know, give my life to Jesus. Lead me into the sinner's path.
Okay, what's your name?
Brent.
Brent, say the prayer with me. Heavenly Father.
Heavenly Father.
Lord, I ask you to come into my life.
Lord, I ask you to come into my life.
And to guide my life.
And to guide my
and
life.
Keep me in Jesus' name.
And keep me in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much. Tell me something. We have a little thing going on with the team.
Mm-hmm.
Be honest. Who do you think is the weakest link? Who not beating you, Who is at the bottom of the barrel?
Gosh.
I mean, give a name.
I thought it was a Christian thing.
Somebody gotta lose. Somebody
has to. Okay, I mean, who is the weakest link? I know I can answer that, so no. I already answered that.
Yeah. Who you think?
I don't think anybody is the weakest link.
Okay.
But I would. Who can't beat me?
Who will come second? Yeah. Who can't beat you?
Saying that I'm gonna.
You first.
Okay, I'm first. Who comes second? Nataki.
Nataki.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, share a potential.
All right. So who you think coming last?
Oh God, dude.
this is my interview.
Somebody had to come last.
Somebody had to come last.
Actually, no, because there's a three. So if I'm first,
what these people with these? Who is
if
coming
I'm first,
last?
If not, is second, the girl from Tobago is third.
It is. The girl from Tobago stood. It is the Emerge Gospel Challenge 2018. Look out for this young man. He is you need to keep your eye on him, alright? Thank you so much, bro.
Yeah.
Alright, good.
Okay. That's it?
Yes, I.
I thought I was saying.
Let's get this ball a rolling one time. Yo, what's up? My name is Jadee, and it's the Emerge Gospel Challenge 2018, the Trinidad and Tobago version. We have our first young lady here. I just want to get this business out of the way. Good night, ma'am. How are you?
Good night. I'm fine.
Here's your vouchers from Wendy's and from King's Lounge. Who are you?
My name is Jadee. Thomas, and I'm from Tobago.
I hear people calling you June around the place. Where did the name June come from?
I think it's because of the way my name is spelled. My name is spelled like June, but it's hyphenated. So it's J-U-N-E accent. So.
Not to be mistaken with April, May, or October. But so it's Jadee. Tell me something. As a gospel artist, right? Mm-hmm. When we come off a stage, we are sometimes bombarded by autographs, pictures, but then there's the more reality side, the mm-hmm. life side. People come to you with different scenarios.
Mm-hmm.
Picture this scenario. A young lady comes to you and she says, I suspect my husband is cheating. And she did some investigation and guess what? He was cheating on her. And to make matters worse, she knows who the individual is. And she says, you know what? I've been hurt once, I've been hurt twice, three times, and I just want to end my life.
Mm-hmm.
What would you say to this person when you come off stage and you have 1 minute because you're rushing to the next show?
Wow. First to begin with, life has its ups and downs. Yes.
Like you're talking to the person. You.
Okay.
I'm that person.
You're that person.
Okay. You're talking to me.
First thing, I may ask, I don't wanna, may not want to go into detail because I mean it's a touchy topic.
Right.
But I will just encourage her because it is a tough situation to be in. I wouldn't be like, I understand how you feel because I may not be in the situation at the same time, but I would reassure her that God's love is sufficient and God's love will supply and really comfort her in that time. I mean, everyone has their toil to go through, their moments in life to go through, but it's just to reassure them that God's love can cover a multitude and she's not short of that. So I just reassure her that God's love can, you know, just keep her whole.
All right, cool. I was supposed to be the person, so you're supposed to actually be ministering to me. But I understand what you're saying,
yeah.
And that's very good. You are doing the song Cycle.
Yes.
That's on the final,
mm-hmm.
which is?
July the 8th.
You ready?
Yes.
You gotta be ready.
Yes.
You gotta be ready. Tell me something. Cycle. When I heard that song,
mm-hmm.
so many situations came back mm-hmm. in my life. Mm-hmm. What cycles that you found yourself, either you were stuck in, mm-hmm. yeah, having trouble to come out of, mm-hmm. and how did you come out of that? Now, you don't have to say your details, yeah. but how you came out of your cycle?
There was a period in my life where I was very emotional. I was emotionally unstable. And it kept happening over and over. And I just had to come to the realization that I have to leave everything to God. Literally. Just leave everything to God and He will take care of it. Sometimes when the situation comes, we forget that and we end up right where we started.
Right.
But the mindset has to come back that leave everything to God and it's going to work out fine. Yeah.
Your coach is Shelly, yeah?
Yes, she is awesome.
In 30 seconds, tell me what it is that you already learned from Shelly.
Shelly is amazing. She has taught me some techniques for my low notes and as well as my high notes, and she's awesome. Awesome.
Quickly,
awesome.
Without thinking, who you think is the weakest link in this competition? Call somebody, don't give me that.
I'm not who calling you? Anyone's name. I'm
who
not calling anyone's name.
Link?
No, I'm not calling anyone's name. Because on the night, that weakest link, whoever we may think it may be the strongest link on the night. So I'm not going to say, well, so-so-so is the weakest link. No.
That's a couple.
I'm being honest. That's because these persons, you know, they're shockers. So I'm just being honest. That weakest person that we may think is weak may be the strongest person on the night.
Well, thank you very much.
No problem. You're welcome.
It is the Emerge Gospel Challenge 2018, the Trinidad and Tobago version. Yo, they ready? Let's find out.
July 8th, 6 p.m. at Central Bank Auditorium. Only one will emerge. It's a red carpet affair. Dress code in effect. Come out and support the next generation of ministers for Emerge Gospel Challenge Grand Finale. Remember, on this night, your vote will only count if you have a ticket. International judges. Sunday Best Season 5 winner, Joshua Rogers from the USA. Manager of the Stars, Apostle Verrill Howard. Multi-award winning gospel artist, Sherwin Gardner. And guest appearances by some of the top local gospel ministers. To vote for the People's Choice Award, go to EmergeTrinidad.com. Tickets cost only $150. Call 868-791-4759 or email info@EmergeTrinidad.com for tickets. Powered by ACTN, The Voice. Only one will emerge.
Well, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
All right, let me just give you a voucher. Some King's Lounge and Wendy's. One time, get
thank you.
Business out of the way. Who are you?
I am Delis.
Delis, tell me something a little bit, not too much, about how you started in ministry.
I originally came from a singing family. So my parents would have more so raised my brother and I.
Are you nervous?
No, I'm okay.
Your hands trembling a little bit.
No.
So you came from a singing family.
Yes.
If I was to say to you, Delis, I don't think you cut out this. I think that you're probably too shy. I think that you're not ready for this. If I was to say to you, I don't know if you're ready for this ministry life, this artist life. If I was to say that, what would you say to me?
No, this is the first time you met me. I know first impressions come, but probably when you hear me singing, you'd say otherwise.
Let me put yourself in this scenario. This is a scenario. You win this thing. Because you believe you're going to win, right?
Yes.
So you win this thing and you get invited. As part of the package, they get the contestants get to go to Bahamas to perform for the FanFest. FanFest is a big concert in Bahamas. It's huge. All of Bahamas comes out. Scenario, you walk on stage, it's time for you to minister, but the music don't play. You look back and they say, what do you do at that point? And what do you do? This is the stage. What do you do at that point?
So what do you want me to do? Do exactly what
you
I would do?
You tell me exactly how it's going to go down. No music playing?
Well,
crowd.
Firstly, give a brief introduction. You know, I am Delis Nances. And introduce, I am the...
That's how you... I want you to do exactly what you're going to do.
Sitting or standing?
No, you can sit. Just okay. Say what you...
I will be, hi, I'm Dalice Nancis, and I am the Emerge Gospel Challenge winner. And I came to minister to you, and I'll introduce the song. And hopefully within that period, the musicians are ready.
Hopefully.
If they're not, then start singing.
All right, good, good, very good. Tell me something, be honest. Who you think is the weakest man in this thing? Who you think, not beating you, who you think is the weakest? Call the name.
He got
it. you can't imagine. This is the lead. This is the vote for the information. I'm sure it's going to be there at some point. And it's all about the Emerge Gospel Challenge. Trinidad and Tobago 2018. Yo, the thing will be sell off on the finals. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Yeah, congratulations. You're the team.
We are getting closer to the grand finale. So go to EmergeTrinidad.com to catch up on all of the episodes of Emerge Gospel Challenge Season 4 that you missed. Only one will emerge.
Good evening.
Good evening.
How are you?
Good.
Let's get the business out of the way. Here is your voucher from Wendy's and King's Lounge Barber Spa, the premier barber spa for men.
Thanks.
All right, so listen. Who are you?
I am Carousel.
Carousel?
Yeah.
You seem very focused. Mm-hmm. You seem like you have a head on. What's your story? Meaning, 30 seconds or less, give me your testimony.
Oh boy. Okay, well, I born, raised in church. Sing, backups mostly, then worship leader.
So you never run out there in the carnival and the juvie and the mass?
Nah.
You don't know what that is?
No. Only see it on TV.
That's very good.
Yeah.
That's very good.
Yeah.
Ask me this question. There are a couple gospel artists that they sing on secular rhythm, Jaronet, myself, mm-hmm. Isaac Blackman.
Mm-hmm.
What are your thoughts on a gospel minister?
Uh-huh.
Singing on a worldly beat.
As long as persons who listen to the song don't literally only hear the worldly song from the beat, fine. So stuff like what you sang, Janus, I hear their song,
right?
Not the beat.
What you say to the person that says, "Oh, is it transferring a spirit and them music has spirit on it?" What you say to that?
God make music.
Hey.
God make music, so it's what you put on it. If it positive, if it worshiping God, if it pleasing to God, then I have no problem with that.
We doing scenarios quickly.
Mm.
This scenario, you're driving through Port of Spain, mm-hmm. and you pass by one of those gay bars, and then you see somebody from your worship team, because you are the leader of the worship team,
oh,
and they're coming out of the gay bar,
mm.
and they kiss a girl. Sunday morning you see that person in church.
Uh-huh.
How you think you might deal with that situation? As a worship leader.
As a worship leader. Okay. It's all about approach. It's all about what you say and how you say it. Make sure that this whatever you say is in love.
Right.
And not to offend and to bring down and to chastise anybody. But as long as, okay, well, you bring it up, what I realize, you did something or whatever, if you want to talk about it, if you have any issues or whatever. Just make sure I do it in love, though.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay, agreed. I understand. So we're doing something here. We want to know, and be very honest.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, and my interview, you have to answer me. Who you think is the weakest link on this show?
Who
is at the bottom of the barrel?
You
can't do it, nothing. I got your back. I have your back. Nobody can do it.
I don't think it have any weak persons, though.
Who you think will come last?
I don't know.
You coming first?
I want to hope so.
You sure you're coming first?
Yeah, I think, yeah.
Who you think will come second?
I don't know. Somebody that's really good. Yes.
But you sure you're winning?
Yes.
All right. Well, yeah. Listen, it is it's Emerge. The Emerge Gospel Challenge. 2018 is the Trinidad and Tobago version, and you're gonna have her information to vote for her. She don't seem like she's sure she went in, but I'm sure she have a plan. Thank you very
You're
much.
Right.
That's what we wanna hear.
Yeah.
That's what we wanna hear. Let's go. Let's get the business started. Oh, that was horrible. But let's get the business out of the way. Good evening.
Good evening.
How are you?
Okay.
Well, here's your voucher from Wendy's and King's Lounge Barber Spa. 15% off. It's the premier barber spa for men. And who are you?
I'm a human.
Yo, yeah. This is going to be good. I like this interview already. Human, you come from a musical family?
Somewhat, yes.
Yeah, what is, because are you under pressure because your brother is a mega super gospel star and you are not yet? Are you, you feel yourself coming under some pressure?
I'm okay being Solange, you know. I'm not pressured at all.
Right.
Solange made it. I could.
Okay. And you have been, I see you are wrong.
Yeah.
You've been knocking on the gospel door for, would it be correct for me to say you've been knocking on the door for a while? I saw you on stages.
So I was approaching the door to knock.
Right.
So, yeah.
What do you think are the disadvantages and the advantages of being an upcoming gospel artist?
Okay, I think the advantages would be being able to reach more people than you could just within the four walls of your church, because being a gospel artist doesn't necessarily mean you're just a church leader. They actually go out. That's my definition of a gospel artist. Anybody could be a gospel artist out on the streets.
Right.
The disadvantages I would say is that you're always in the limelight, so people are always quick to point fingers at you if you mess up, or if at some point in time your conviction may not match their own.
Right.
So yeah.
You are here because you were not here from the beginning. How is your experience thus far?
So far it's been welcoming. Everybody is cool. Everybody is chilled so far. I feel like if I was a part of it from the beginning.
Right. If somebody, you're looking out there and somebody wants to get into ministry, what would you say to that person, 30 seconds or less?
I would say get to market yourself, get to know some people, don't only stay within yourself, because you have to reach out in order to be, well, in order for your craft to be known, basically.
All right, cool. Yeah. Now, I know you're new and everything, and you're about to win this thing, right?
Yes.
You're about to win, no, hands down.
Yeah.
Who you think is at the bottom of the barrel? Who you think, like, you know, who you think is going to come last in this thing? Because there must be a person at
last. Well, I mean, whoever don't win last, so it have 9 people to lose. So.
Because you're going to win.
Yeah.
Is there any one particular person you think that, hey, you know what? That person is at the bottom of the barrel.
If I knew names, really bad with names.
Because, yeah, we were let slide because she
backstage,
knew.
The backstage, though.
Yeah. They can't do anything.
Yeah, just one of them backstage. Yeah.
Listen, it is the Gospel Emerge. It's the Emerge Gospel Challenge 2018. It's the Trinidad and Tobago version. Yo, shout somebody, shout them out. Shout them.
I want to say hi to girl like. Everybody.
Yeah. Everybody.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. Okay, all the best.
On July 8th, 6 p.m. at Central Bank Auditorium, only one will emerge. It's a red carpet affair. Dress code in effect. Come out and support the next generation of ministers for Emerge Gospel Challenge Grand Finale. Remember, on this night, your vote will only count if you have a ticket. International judges, Sunday Best Season 5 winner, Joshua Rogers from the USA. Manager of the Stars, Apostle Verrill Howard. Multi-award-winning gospel artist, Sherwin Gardner. And guest appearances by some of the top local gospel ministers. To vote for the People's Choice Award, go to EmergeTrinidad.com. Tickets cost only $150. Call 868-791-4759 or email info@EmergeTrinidad.com for tickets. Powered by ACTN The Voice. Only one will emerge.
All right, guys, we had a wonderful episode thus far with none other than Mr. Jadee himself. Brand ambassador, entrepreneur, as well as gospel artist. Yes?
Yeah, all of the above. Praise God.
Praise the Lord.
Friend of the family, son of, you know, child of God. I'm going to say son of God.
Son of God. You see, this is why we love him. Yes, this is why we love Jadee.
Yeah,
so, Jadee,
yeah.
Tell us, you interviewed the contestants. What you thought about them thus far?
Well, you know what? First of all, I just want to say congratulations to all the contestants and kudos to them and encouragement to them that they would even take the time and believe in themselves and believe in what God is doing with them to come and enter. So that alone is just a respect. I do think, though, that there's some, of course, everybody, even myself, have room for work
and improvements.
And this is a gospel challenge for young upcoming gospel ministers. So, of course, I would see the ripeness. I would see the nervousness. I would see things, how they would handle and how they would not handle. I believe there's a bunch of excellent young people. One or two stand out.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna, obviously I'm not gonna say
who they are.
But on the night, the thing is with finals and final night, you never know who could come
from the ground
B
up
to position
A. Yeah.
You know what I mean? And you never know. There are tricks, people are tricks out there, they be acting like, and then on the night is just, you understand? So I think that they have a willingness to really learn. Each and every one of them have this urge.
Yeah.
And a willingness to learn, and each and every one of them love the Lord, which is most important.
I see you being like the devil's advocate tonight.
That was what you only thought about? No, I was just being
asking them, right?
Yo, that's when you're
cool.
Coming in Maxi,
you gotta find out. Yeah.
When you're coming in Maxi on Jadee's vlog, that's how it is good on. So I just,
but it you know is, yes, let me hear about this.
The thing is that on when you go on interviews, different parts, as I was explaining to them before, around the world, people act things differently.
It's true.
Sometimes I just go to an interview and they plan for you. Not to make you look bad, but to see what you're made of.
Yeah.
So instantly somebody will say, yeah, well, you know, the Bible speaks about encouraging 14 about long hair. What are you as a raster? And,
yeah.
You know what I mean? So they just.
So they, get, should, they should always be on target for any question at any time.
You will never know what question will come, but at least you have some sort of a response that can handle and, you know, facilitate what you are about.
Well, I'm thinking that this was a wonderful episode. Let me tell you something.
Yeah? I
enjoyed myself behind the cameras too while you were taking over.
Yeah. People start calling people names.
Hey.
People like, yo, this one not winning. People like,
I started to get frightened.
I don't want to say nothing.
Right.
So it's your boy Stephen John. I have two amazing talents, Whitney and Kenesha. And we're here to destroy all the other coaches. So you better stay locked right here every Sunday, 6:30.
Guys, I'm really excited to work with my two contestants, Nataki and Delis. They have so much potential and I'm ready to bring it.
I have two amazing contestants, Nikisha and Celeste. And trust me, we are going to come out to crush everybody here.
Hey guys, I am Wendell Bompart, and you have to remember to tune in to ACTN The Voice every Sunday from 6:30 p.m. for the Emerge Gospel Challenge. I don't know about the other coaches that have two contestants. I just need one, and one will do it. Don't worry.
Hi guys, this is Coach Shelley. You guys know me for being the sweet coach, but I have the beautiful Janae and the talented Brandon. And we are going to create compelling performances and powerful memories for our audience for the competition. So to the other coaches, the gloves are off. No sweet Shelly for this one. We got this in the bag. We got this Janae and Brandon.
Today I was able to meet Carousel, the contestant that I will be working on for this challenge. Let me tell you, I was blown away the first time I heard her. So I was just so excited when they told me I am going to be working with her. Let me tell you, I was able to hear so much of her heart today concerning what she wanted to do with the youth and so forth. And those key elements are very important to creating a young gospel artist to represent Trinidad and Tobago. On top of that, she is mad talented with her vocals. So when she reaches into the booth or step on the stage, let me tell you, she's really going to bring the very best and represent the kingdom of God and of course Trinidad and Tobago. So I am now going to be able to work with her to polish up all the ends and, you know, to ensure that she always gives her best. I'm excited and I believe I am on Carousel's side and I believe she has something to offer and you'll have to watch out for it. Look out for Carousel.